I'm going to be starting off with my topic, which is basically CARES. And this is an acronym that I created for a technique that I call as corneal allogenic intrastromal ring segment, CAIRS. I must say that I do have a patent pending for special trephines, devices, and process to create these segments, as well as for CARES and various types of shaped corneal segments. The need for this procedure, we must understand that the prevalence of keratoconus, which was originally thought to be about 1 in 2,000, with recent studies is shown to be much more. In a study on the prevalence in pediatric patients in Riyadh in Saudi Arabia, it was shown to be as high as 1 in 21%. And generally now it's taken as 1 in 200 patients have some kind of subtle abnormal findings which need further investigation. So keratoconus is really becoming a much more commonly seen procedure. So seen disease, basically also because of much better investigative modalities that are now available to screen patients for. The current treatment, of course, is cross-linking, and cross-linking is a very good treatment, but by itself, it has a limited role in regularizing corneal topography or in improving vision. So, this, if it can be combined with a technique that can also improve the patient for vision for patients, it would be the ideal situation. Intracorneal ring segments have, of course, already been tried and are being used for this in the form of Intax, Kera rings, Ferrara rings, Mayo rings, and so on and so forth. But all of these are made of PMMA or plastic, and though they are effective in improving the quality of vision, they can be associated with complications as seen in this. This is my own series of patients, all the photographs, which you can see the migration, the overriding of the segments, the extrusions and the melts that can happen with the overlying corneal necrosis and melt. You can have intrusions, which has even been reported in literature to cause acute high drops years later. You can have infectious keratitis, which can even lead on to the need for a therapeutic keratoplasty. And up to a 30% rate of complications can occur with synthetic implants, especially if you're not very careful about the thickness of the corneas that you're going to be implanting on, or the type of keratoconus that you're implanting on. So here is the technique that I'd like to share with you today. And this is basically the CARE segment. And you can see that that's the trephine that I've designed for making these segments. These segments are made from human donor corneosclereal rims. And I'm going to show you this video as to how to prepare this. This is a donor corneosclereal rim which has been mounted on an artificial anterior chamber. And the first thing you do is remove all the epithelium from the rim and remove all the endothelium. Here's a special trephine that I have devised, which has two concentric rings, as you can see. Just go back a bit. It has two concentric rings, one within the other, and you use this to punch out a ring of corneal tissue. Now, this corneal tissue is pure stroma because you've removed all the epithelium and the endothelium, and you get this ring, which is then cut further into two segments. These are simple cataract instruments that I've modified to be able to implant these segments in. The femtosecond laser dissected channels have already been created in this patient's eye, and now I'm implanting these segments, and you can see that it goes in very easily. I've got entry incisions on both sides, and so I can use a combination of pushing in and or sliding it in and then drawing it in from the other side further using a reverse Sensky. And in patients who are progressive or younger patients who are showing signs of progression, I always combine it also with cross-linking. Here's a post-operative video showing the CARE segment in situ, and I implant these segments at 50% depth. So you can see it's a very quiet eye, 50% depth as compared to the much deeper depth that is required post synthetic segments, where you need to put it at about 80% in order to decrease the risk of extrusion and melt. You can see the two segments there, a superior and an inferior segment, lying very quiet and hardly visible. So what are the disadvantages again of synthetic implants? It's not just the complications, but also the fact that you cannot implant them in very thin or very steep corneas that are beyond a certain limit. Also, the effect that you get can be limited because you have to implant it by force deep in the cornea to avoid complications. Unlike this, CARES can be implanted in advanced cases, so there's no limit to the amount of thinning. You can implant it in extremely thin corneas also because there's no risk of overlying melts or necrosis. You know that in DALT, you're actually implanting the entire cornea onto just a bed of Desmet's membrane, pre-Desmet's layer and endothelium. So obviously this CARES can also be implanted in advanced cases, and I have done it up to 80 diopters of KMAX. You can also implant it, the advantages in mild and early cases. You can implant it at 50% depth or even more superficial if you want to, so you can get a greater effect, though I prefer 50% depth. And you can also implant arc segments up to 360 degrees very easily, unlike say, in PMMA, where it's much more difficult to take big arc segments around. So you get a much wider pool of patients where this can be used, right from mild to advanced cases. You can do it in simultaneous with cross-linking. You can implant it in patients who have already undergone cross-linking, and you can also implant it in patients with no documented progression to improve vision. You can also put in keratoglobus, PMD, post-classic ectasia, etc. And the best part is you can also use it to treat MELS, migration, extrusion, etc., which are complications related to synthetic segments. So here you can see a segment with overlying melt. This is an intact segment, and this is how the care segment looks in comparison. You can see very quiet. So this is a video I'd like to share with you, which shows this synthetic segment melt that I'm going to treat with a care segment. It's an interesting video, but for the sake of time, I'm going to run through it. That's the area of melt, and you'll see the area of melt is generally larger than what you think clinically, because there's this epithelium that's covering a lot of the area. And so what I've done is I've just pulled this synthetic segment out, and I cut the care segment into the desired length and thickness. And I put these anchoring sutures on either side, anchoring the segment to the cornea, and bridging sutures, which basically go over the care segment but not through, just to hold it in place in the post-operative period. And here's the post-op appearance. You can see this is before suture removal. This is 3 months later, and you can see this patient with a synthetic segment on one side and a care segment on the other side. So this is a beautiful way of treating these patients. Here's a topography, which shows a tomography, azoscity, which shows very well-placed segments. You can see that the posterior curvature is increased, the anterior curvature is flattened to an improvement in the spherical equivalent, which means that the refractive error also comes down. We've seen that all these patients have improvement in almost all parameters. The way it acts is, of course, by Baraka's thickness law, which means that when you add thickness to the center, flattens. Now, in our results, we saw that it flattens the steep cornea, regularizes the topography, centralizes the cone. It decreases the aberration, both the spherical equivalent is decreased. It also decreases, of course, by default, the dependence of the patient on contact lenses for clear vision. The best part is it spares the visual axis like other additive procedures like ICRS. It's reversible, replaceable, and adjustable. I'm just going to share with you some of the results here, post-operative topographies. And you can see a huge amount of regularization of the corneal topography. The vision improved from 624 part to 69 part, and a great decrease in the cylinder. Some other topographies, patient with a high cylinder of 5 diopters, which is flattened out quite a bit here, and you can see the difference map showing the great amount of improvement in the cylinder with shorter arc leg segments that were used. Here's a preoperative picture of a patient who's got a steepening, inferior steepening, and I've put a single segment for this decentered cone, and you can see postoperatively the flattening that's also seen in the difference map, giving you very good results. Again, an asymmetric segment, just single segment placed below for an inferiorly decentered cone. You can see up to 15 diopters of flattening here. Lots of similar results. Here's a patient, very interesting patient, who's, if you can see here, got 20/120 uncorrected, post-operatively improved to 20/30. And you can see the differential flattening that's brought about, more flattening in the steeper areas and less flattening in the less steep areas, which is ideal and which is what we would like to have. The cylinders drop from 7 to 2.5 diopters, and you can see the thicker segments that are here. The other eye, we didn't need as much as effect, so we placed thinner segments, and you can see correspondingly we have managed to get a lesser effect as we would desire. The cylinder, the pre-op spherical, the sphere refraction improved from -1.25 cylinder to 0.5 cylinder. So you can get excellent results depending on how you're tailoring the segments. Again, a patient with one eye cares and cross-linking, and you can see a lot of flattening that's happened. The other only cross-linking was done because of financial constraints, and you can see that there's not effective cross-linking, and this is a beautiful comparison which shows the additional effect of cares on these patients. You can also do this in very steep corneas. You can see this patient's about 67, 68 diopters, 72 diopters actually steepest, which is dropped down to 59, and we avoided DALC in these patients. There's another patient where we got about 20 diopters flattening, very steep cornea. Again, in this patient, we avoided DALC. So you can see these procedures can be done for all the entire gamut of keratoconus from mild to severe. Again, ASOST showing very quiet eyes. We've done more than 140 patients so far, and we published our results in JRS, the initial results. You can also get insurance for this, and we are doing that in our country, but also in US and other countries, you can also process it as a lamellar graft, and therefore that has an additional advantage. And to conclude, I'd like to say that you know, this is allogenic tissue, so it doesn't have disadvantages of synthetic tissue. In addition, it has good corneal integration, less complications. It's easily available, at least in our country, and it's easy to perform. It's effective, stable, simple, safe, reversible, adjustable, and it's got a very low level of rejection. And I can go through that later, but for reasons of time, I'm going to stop now. The reason why the level of rejection is very low. And with that, I'll come to the end of my talk. I think, Aileen, you've also done CARES yourself, and also it's being done in many countries now, including US. And I'll be happy to help anyone who'd be interested in doing this technique or starting this technique. The trephines are manufactured by a company in India, and I'd be happy to put you in touch with them. Thank you so much.